In Flight School, we learn about the four forces of flight. And that these forces need to be balanced for steady, straight flight. We learn that lift and drag depend on angle of attack and on airspeed. We learn a good dose of aerodynamic theory, but it all remains pretty static. Whereas practical flight training can be pretty dynamic. And so I wondered if a real-time visualization of the forces at play might narrow the gap between theory and practice. I first looked for a simulation, and although there are many flight simulators, I found none that visualized the forces in a simple way. So I tried to develop one of my own. And here it is, FOFSIM, a forces of flight simulation. FOFSIM is free and should run on any device without installation. The link to FOFSIM is in the description below. Before we take a closer look at the functions of FOFSIM, I'd like to draw your attention to the presets selection. Here you can select from a wide variety of pre-recorded flight states right away, from takeoff to climb, cruise, descent, approach, and landing. And many more flight states like stall, inverted flight, vertical climb, vertical dive, and even a looping. After loading a preset, you can take control over the aircraft. The left slider controls the power setting. And the right slider controls the elevator. If the sliders don't work for you, you can also use the buttons at the bottom. The buttons on the left control the power setting, and the buttons on the right control the elevator. At the left you have readouts for airspeed, pitch, an angle of attack on the wings and on the elevator. At the right you have readouts for altitude, vertical speed and G-load. When you start FOFSIM, the aircraft sits on the ground. Here we see that weight is balanced by the opposing ground forces, which act on the wheels. Weight is drawn in magenta, and the ground forces are drawn in brown. The table in the right upper corner shows all forces and their colors. The first column shows the amount of each force in kilogram. We use kilogram instead of Newton because that is more familiar to most. Weight and ground forces are currently both 750 kilogram. All other forces are still zero. Now let's pause the sim for a moment and set takeoff power by pushing the power slider full forward. Now let's continue. We see that the aircraft accelerates 30 knots, 40 knots, 50 knots, and let's pause again. Now we see two more forces, lift, which is drawn in blue, and drag, which is drawn in red. Lift already carries 324 kilogram of our weight. And drag is still small and opposes just a little thrust. Therefore the resultant is still pointing forward and the aircraft is still accelerating. We also have a velocity vector, which is drawn in cyan. The velocity vector shows the direction of movement and its length shows the speed. Cyan line parallel to the velocity vector show the airflow at the wing and the airflow at the elevator. Orange lines show the chord line of the wings and the chord line of the elevator. So the angle between the orange and cyan lines therefore show the angle of attack of the wings and the angle of attack of the elevator. At 50 knots we rotate by pulling the elevator slider slightly backwards. Now the aircraft took off and we trim for a climb with about 65 knots. Now we are climbing with about 65 knots, but the whole takeoff sequence was way too fast to realize what was going on. So let's go back to the point where we reached our takeoff speed. I paused the sim and before we continue, we lock the speed. This prevents the aircraft from accelerating and gives us more time to study what's going on. Now we continue and pull the elevator slider slightly backward. Here we see that the nose gear gets light and the nose slightly rotates upwards. This happens because the elevator is deflected upwards and therefore the airflow hits the elevator from above, which causes a downward force on the elevator. This downward force causes a rotational moment that rotates the elevator downwards. We can visualize the rotational moments by selecting all in the moments drop-down. Now we see all rotational moments. Currently the moments caused by the main gear and by lift rotate the nose down, whereas the moments caused by the nose gear and the elevator rotate the nose up. The second column of the forces table also shows the rotational moments of all forces. The moments are shown in kilogram force meter, that's the moment created by 1 kilogram on a lever of 1 meter. Because the sum of all moments currently is zero, there is no change in rotation. If we pull the elevator slider backwards, we see how the moments change. Most notably, how the moment caused by the elevator increases and the moment caused by the lightened nose gear decreases. Very short imbalances cause the nose to rotate until the moments are balanced again. If we lock the pitch, we prevent the aircraft from rotating into a new balance. So we can get a better view of the imbalance. If we pull the elevator back, we get a yellow resultant moment that rotates the nose upward. Now we unlock the pitch again, and the aircraft rotates until the moments are balanced again. If we pull the elevator slider back a bit more, the nose gear leaves the ground. Now it's important to note that rotating the nose upward also causes an increase in angle of attack at the wings. That's the angle between the orange chord line of the wings and the cyan airflow. And this increase in angle of attack causes an increase in lift. Next, we will unlock the speed, which allows the aircraft to accelerate. Now, due to the increase in speed, lift became larger than weight, and the resultant force points upwards. This caused the aircraft to accelerate upwards. In other words, the aircraft began to climb. So this was a pretty detailed look at what happens during takeoff. Next, we retract flaps, reduce power a bit, and pitch for a climb with 70 knots. If the aircraft is in a stable flight condition, like in this climb, all forces and moments are in balance. And luckily, FOFSIM has a special balance view that visualizes that beautifully. Let's select the balance view. The balance view splits each force into two components. One component that acts parallel to the direction of flight, and another component that acts normal to the direction of flight. This makes sense because drag, by definition, always acts parallel to the direction of flight, whereas lift, by definition, always acts normal to the direction of flight. So by drawing the components one after each other, starting from the center of gravity, it's easy to see if and how they balance each other. The forces table also reflects this splitting. The FD column shows all components that act parallel to the direction of flight, and the ND column shows all components that act normal to the direction of flight. Now we see that during a climb, thrust is balanced by the rearward acting component of weight and drag. And lift is balanced by the normal component of weight. So that's the balance in a climb. Notice that lift is a little less than weight during a climb. Yes, you heard right, lift is less than weight during a climb, and that's because the rearward acting component of weight is balanced by thrust. So lift only needs to balance the normal component of weight. This comes to extreme in a vertical climb, where the whole weight is balanced by thrust and there's no lift. During a climb, we usually pitch for the desired airspeed. If we are too slow, then we pitch the nose down. And if we are too fast, then we pitch the nose up. Pitching is done by pushing or pulling on the stick or yoke, and then trimming away the control pressure. Both actions cause a deflection of the elevator. Whilst pushing or pulling on stick or yoke deflects the elevator only as long as we push or pull, trimming takes away the control pressure and makes this deflection permanent. In the sim, the elevator slider offers no resistance, so it immediately trims the elevator, much like an autopilot would do. Now let's take a peek under the hood and find out how an aircraft finds the correct speed after a change in pitch, so that all forces get rebalanced again. Now let's pause the sim again so that we have more time to see what's going on. Now we can see that deflecting the elevator causes a change of the elevator's chord line in orange relative to the oncoming airflow in cyan. For example, if we pitch down, the rear end of the elevator is deflected downward and the airflow hits the elevator from below. This causes an upward force on the elevator that rotates the tail up. Let's continue. The rotation continues until the elevator is again aligned with the airflow. In other words, if we change the deflection of the elevator, the chord line of the elevator always weather vanes into the oncoming airflow. This causes the chord line of the elevator always to be pretty much parallel to the airflow. Therefore, the deflection of the elevator controls the angle of attack at which the airflow hits the aircraft and also the wings. This was a super important fact to remember. The deflection of the elevator controls the angle of attack. Now, if we pitch up, we increase the angle of attack at which the airflow hits the aircraft. This increases lift. And because lift now is larger than the normal component of weight, the aircraft accelerates in the direction of lift. In other words, the aircraft steepens its climb. Now, steepening the climb also changes the balance of forces in the direction of flight. Because the component of weight that acts in the direction of flight increases. This imbalance causes the aircraft to slow down until drag decreased enough so that the component of weight and drag are again in balance with thrust. The aircraft continues to steepen its climb until it slowed down enough so that generated lift and the normal component of weight are in balance again. It takes a few oscillations for the aircraft to settle at the speed where the wing creates just the right amount of lift for the angle of attack set by the deflection of the elevator. And now the aircraft has found a new balance and is climbing at a slower speed and a higher climb rate. If we pitch down, the opposite is happening. Now the elevator caused the angle of attack to decrease, and the aircraft flattens its climb until it's sped up enough so that the wing creates the right amount of lift for the now lower angle of attack. Again, it takes a few oscillations for the aircraft to find a new balance. Now the aircraft has found a new balance and is climbing at a higher speed and a lower climb rate. Next, let's take a look at leveling off. When we level off, we first pitch down to decrease our angle of attack so that the thereby caused decrease in lift causes a downward acceleration to level flight. But this causes a further imbalance because now there is no more rearward acting component of weight. Therefore, the aircraft will speed up and we must decrease our angle of attack even more to prevent the aircraft from climbing. Now we can also reduce to cruise power. And after some time, we found the right angle of attack and a new balance for the aircraft in level flight. Notice that in level flight, lift is equal to an opposite to weight, and thrust is equal and opposite to drag. Furthermore, notice that there is currently a small force of 16 kilograms on the elevator. This force is necessary to balance the downward pitching moment of lift that occurs because the center of pressure lies slightly behind the center of gravity. A position slightly behind the center of gravity is preferable because it causes the moments created by the wings and the elevator to act against each other, which provides for aircraft stability. Again, we can visualize the moments by selecting all in the moments drop-down. Here you can see that the moment created by the elevator is balanced by the moment created by the wings. Next, let's see what's going on during a descent. We can start a descent by reducing power. To better see what's happening, let's pause the sim for a moment and reduce power. Now thrust is less than drag, and the aircraft will slow down. Let's continue. Slowing down the aircraft causes a decrease in lift and drag. And now lift is less than weight, which causes a downward acceleration. In other words, the aircraft begins to descend. This causes the airflow to hit the elevator at a slightly larger angle of attack. Therefore, the chord line of the elevator weather vanes into the airflow. And the aircraft pitches down. We can make the rotational moment caused by the elevator better visible by locking the pitch of the aircraft. Now we reduce power again. And here we see how the increasing angle of attack on the elevator changes its moment. This causes an imbalance that pitches the aircraft down. Pitching down also changes the balance of forces in the direction of flight, because it causes an increasing forward acting component of weight. This imbalance causes the aircraft to regain speed. So the aircraft speeds up until drag is in balance with thrust and the component of weight. The aircraft continues to steepen its descent until it's sped up enough so that the generated lift and the normal component of weight are in balance again. Again, the aircraft needs a few oscillations to find this new balance. Now the aircraft has found a new balance and is descending. Notice that drag is balanced by the forward acting component of weight and the remaining thrust. Also notice that the aircraft flies with exactly the same speed as before we started our descent. That's because we didn't change the deflection of the elevator. So the elevator commands the same angle of attack. And therefore the same airspeed is required for the wing to create enough lift to oppose weight. And that's the so-called trim speed which the aircraft holds if we don't touch stick or yoke. So now I think it's time to land. We've covered a lot of ground in this video. And I'm very glad you're still with me. Landing is a bit tricky because you don't see the runway. So all you have is this altitude readout. I've set landing flaps and trimmed for 60 knots. So let's see what we see. 50 feet, 40, 30, 20. Not my best landing, but it won't get any better today. So thanks again for staying with me. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like to give FOFSIM a try, you're very welcome to do so. The link is in the description below. If you find it useful, pass the word. And as always, thanks for flying with us and hope to see you on board again soon.